Hello children, welcome back to your English class. Children, in the previous video we started with the first chapter of our English literature book. The title of the story was The Open Window, written by H.H. Munro, who's also known by the name of Saki. The story is about a young boy named Frampton Nuttall who goes to village for a few days on doctor's advice to improve his nervous condition. After reaching the village, he starts visiting few of the houses, and during one such visit to a house, he meets a young lady, a young girl, who and they start having conversation. Now, during the conversation, the girl mentions about a tragedy that occurred in her aunt's life around 3 years back. Now, what was the tragedy? We'll come to know when we'll continue with the story. So, without any delay, let's start.
You may wonder why we keep that window wide open on an October afternoon, said the niece, indicating a large French window that opened onto a lawn. It is quite warm for the time of the year, said Frampton. But has that window got anything to do with the tragedy? Now, Frampton and the girl were sitting in the living area, and behind Frampton there was a large window which was open, and it was a French window. A window that opens towards a lawn or a garden is called a French window. So when the girl asks Frampton if he is wondering why that window has been kept open, he inquires if keeping the window open has got anything to do with the tragedy. Out through that window, 3 years ago to a day, her husband and her two young brothers went off for their day's shooting. They never came back. In crossing the moor to their favorite snipe shooting ground, they were all three engulfed in a treacherous piece of bog. It had been that dreadful wet summer, you know, and places that were safe in other years gave way suddenly without warning. Their bodies were never recovered. That was the dreadful part of it. Here the child's voice lost its self-possessed note and became falteringly human.
So the girl starts talking about the tragedy, and she tells Frampton that around 3 years ago on that very day, Mrs. Sappleton's husband and her two young brothers started their day, and they went out for shooting, that is for hunting, but they never came back from that hunt. Now they were going for a snipe shooting. Now what is snipe? Snipe is a kind of a bird which has got a short legs, and it has got a long straight bill, that is the beak, and it is generally found in wet marshy areas like swamps, rivers, ponds. And it is very difficult to hunt this kind bird because it has got an erratic flight. It changes directions very quickly and easily. So she says that her uncle and two of Mrs. Sappleton's brothers, they started their day and they went for the hunting of this bird. And in order to reach the area where the birds were found, they had to cross a moor. Now, what is a moor? Moor is a highland which is generally covered with bushes and grass. So, while they were crossing the moor, they stepped onto a bog. Now, what is bog? Bog is an area of wet, muddy ground that is soft. As a result, it is not able to support a heavy body. Now, generally, moor is solid. It has got solid ground, but because that year it had rained quite heavily, so some parts had suddenly turned into like a death trap without anybody knowing about it. So when they were crossing the moor, unluckily they stepped onto a bog, muddy ground, and they were all they fell into it, and their body was covered with the mud, and nobody was able to find their body. Now, while narrating this incident, the so self-composed girl, now she was quite calm and confident, but when she was telling this story, she became a little, she lost her composure, and she started speaking little shakily. Poor aunt always thinks that they will come back someday, they and the little brown spaniel that was lost with them, and walk in at that window just as they used to do. That is why the window is kept open every evening till it is quite dusk. So the girl continues and tells Frampton, she continues with the story and tells him that though the incident occurred like 3 years back, but till today her aunt is hoping of her husband's and her two younger brothers' return, and she believes and she feels that a day will come when her husband, her brother and her dog, that is a spaniel dog, it's a breed of a dog, they will be coming back and they will enter the house the same way they used to do, that is through the window, they and not through the door. And that is why every evening she keeps the window open till it is the dusk time. Now you know what is a dusk. Dusk is that part of the day when it is the day is over and the night has not yet arrived, but it is little dark. It starts getting dark, but it's not actually, it's not totally dark. So that part of the, you know, evening time is called dusk. Poor dear aunt, she has often told me how they went out, her husband with his white waterproof coat over his arm, and Ronnie, her youngest brother, singing Bertie, why do you bound? As he always did to tease her, because she said it got on her nerves. Do you know, sometimes on still quiet evenings like this, I almost get a creepy feeling that they will all walk in through that window. She also tells Frampton that, you know, many times her aunt has told her about her husband and her two brothers, and she has told her that you know, the day they went for hunting, her husband was wearing a white waterproof coat, and her brother went while singing a song, like he used to sing every time he used to go, or in order to tease her he used to sing Bertie, why do you bound, because he knew that whenever he sings this, Mrs. Sepultel gets irritated. And then she also says that many times, you know, whenever she sees that window open, and whenever she recalls how her aunt used to, you know, talk about her husband and her brother, she sometimes had that creepy feeling, that scary feeling, that a day will come when, you know, she will be, you know, seeing her uncle and her, you know, the two of her aunt's brother walking through that window. She broke off with a little shudder. It was a relief to Frampton when the aunt bustled into the room with a whirl of apologies for being late in making her appearance. I hope Vera has been amusing you, she said. She has been very interesting, said Frampton. I hope you don't mind the open window, said Mrs. Sepultel briskly. My husband and brothers will be home directly from shooting, and they always come in this way. They have been out for snipe in the marshes today, so they'll make a fine mess over my poor carpets. So like you menfolk, isn't it? So the girl stops talking about the incident, and she suddenly shivers with, you know, out of fear, you can say. And at that very moment, Mrs. Sepultel enters the room, and she apologizes to Frampton for meeting him so late. And then she asks if Vera has been a good companion, whether she has given him good company. He says that she has been very interesting. She also tells the reason. She, Mrs. Sepultel also tells Frampton that she has kept the window open because her husband and her brothers have gone for hunting, and soon they will be coming back, and they have gone to the marshes, that is a wet area, and because of that their shoes will be totally, you know, covered with mud and such things, and they are going to, you know, enter the house from through that window only, and and when they enter, the carpet that is laid near the window will be totally ruined because of that mud which will be stuck on their shoes.